This is the GSL. In the red, we have our first Terran player. His ID?
Tenants.
Getting resituated in his chair there. Over here in the blue, one of the greatest War 3 players of all time. His micro is impeccable.
Foxlet.
Cannot be pecked.
It cannot be pecked, so just back off, birds.
Yeah.
It's in.
Well, foxes eat bird eggs.
Ooh.
And he is a pretty impeccable fox, Stasis.
He is.
Now, we were talking about rotational symmetry and positional imbalance on this map, and it looks like Lin got the upper hand. The back expansion of our red player, Byun, has its back to Lin, so Lin can drop there a little bit quicker. It's not a huge deal in the matchup, but it's definitely, if you had to choose which position to be at here, you'd want to be at Lin's.
Oh yeah, for sure. Now, we are waiting to see what kind of initial build they're gonna open up with. We've seen these guys go for fast expand. We've seen Banshee rushes. We've seen Marine King Prime style, which I think is getting more pop. Oh.
Okay. We're going to be seeing a Macarax.
Macarax.
Lin taking a page out of the book of a very much less successful Warcraft 3 player in Maka, a.k.a. Town Hall. He's the one that kind of started making barracks at his expansion to hide it. And this is going to make it, obviously, so it's not scouted, and you can go ahead and rush. Now, if Byun doesn't get a quick bunker, he is going to be in a lot of trouble, Tasteless, because it looks like he's going just one barracks expansion build.
Remember, Lin from War 3, he's going to have sick micro. So, I really wonder if Zenix Byun is going to be able to hold this off.
Yeah, this is going to be pretty interesting. You know, it may look cut and dry, but when you're at the top of a ramp, you have some SCVs there as well.
He did see the SCV going back into the main. That was a little bit suspicious.
Hmm. But Byun starts his command center.
Uh-oh.
No. Actually, he's moving his Marines in the center of the map, Tasteless. And
uh-oh.
It looks like Lin going to send his SCVs. He wants to win the Code very badly.
He wants money.
Bit
he wants to go S.
Bye,
bit. Go, 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 go. SCVs come up the ramp.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. He has the WTF face. He's going, oh, my God, this
cancels
is actually
his command
happening.
Center off. Will he be able to hold this? Lin's SCVs do come up. The Marines being rallied in. But really, he's got to be very careful and push these Marines up the ramp. They're attacking a supply depot.
Yeah, he actually mismicroed that. Uh-oh.
Byun doing a good job of holding this off, Tasteless. Right now,
look
it
at
is
the concentration in his face right now.
Oh my, it looks like Lin getting a lot of Marines up here. He's just got too many, Tasteless.
Taking out some
this
feet,
bunker
nice
gets
micro
up, though.
If the bunker completes, the rush is over.
But that won't even mean GG necessarily. Even if Byun holds this, he's down to six SCVs. Oh, here come five more Lins! Lin wants to. Oh! And it looks like Byun is going to take a slight lead here. And you might be like, well, you stopped that all in. But it's six SCVs for Byun, four for Lin. So both of them have completely shattered economies.
If I were.
Supply right now, 15 against 13 with Byun in the lead.
If I were Byun, I'd insta salvage that bunker.
Yes.
And start trying to get back into this.
That is actually very interesting. I actually am going to go ahead and disagree with that momentarily. Because
go ahead.
With mules, you're actually still going to gather so many minerals that you can afford to do other things. Another attack is maybe something that Lin is going to do. He might think he's further behind it than he is, you know? He might be like, well, God, I lost all my SCVs, so he's going to kill me. I better all in one more time.
Maybe. I don't know, actually.
Yeah.
I guess it's possible. Let's see if he does all in.
I got a feeling Lin will. But The thing is, against a bunker on top of a ramp, it will not even come close to working.
I mean, Lynn will get giggle stomped.
Yeah, man.
He'll get raffle stomped if he just tries to do that again.
He'll get giggled out of the place, man.
He will
be snickering and stuff. He'll be so embarrassed. Go home and tell his mom, I hate high school. I hate the GSL. All they do is make fun of my schnurfs.
Call me a schnurf. His mom's like, what's a schnurf? And then she has to call the school, talk to the principal.
Yeah.
Lynn. Oh, my God, he is doing it again.
Yeah.
You were right.
That's why you keep that bunker. Someone that has the all-in mentality will continue to all-in.
I would have sold the bunker.
Yeah.
Because, see, if I didn't all-in like that, I got his SCVs loaded up, I'd be like, all right, now we're going to play a normal game.
Yeah.
That's what I would have done.
I get you, Tasteless. A lot of people would think like that. Artosis always thinks about defense, though. Because
yeah,
he doesn't like to die.
Because Artosis is a Ninja Turtle. He's Donatello and Raphael combined.
And here we go. Lynn going up the ramp.
Okay.
SCV's repairing the bunker. We should be seeing a GG from Lynn. As soon as,
GG.
There it is. And Lynn's all-ins end in defeat and tragedy. Beyond moves on to the finals of Code A to face OGS Talk.
It's going to be a great finals. Lynn got very far in the tournament. Should be very impressed with himself. And he's going to be part of the up-and-down match.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
It's top four in Code A. Not bad, Tasteless.
No, not at all. Quite good, actually.
Yeah. So, Bjorn, good play, solid play. Canceled that command center immediately. Pulled his SCVs. You know, called down some mules. Made a bunker. Did all sorts of stuff, Tasteless. And it made him win because Lynn went with that all-in again. Once an all-inner, Tasteless, always an all-inner. At least in the same game. Very few people will all-in and then realize it's so hard to count those SCVs in the midst of battle.
Oh, yeah.
How many did I really kill? Does he have twice as many? Does he have two more? It's very hard to say. So
yeah.
I don't even truly blame Lynn for going again. But
no, I mean,
when he SCV saw him coming again.
I mean, look, like I said, I would have sold that bunker. Yeah. I would have then lost to the all-in.
Yeah, Lynn would be going on in the finals instead of Tasteless.
Yeah. That would have been terrible.
That would have been a huge upset.
Because I probably would have used one of the Tasteless builds during that game. So, but, you know, for instance, if I had done the SCV all-in, I would not have attacked again. Because that's just the way I played. I'm like, well, we're both basically knocked back into the Stone Age.
Yeah.
And that's fine because I'm comfortable playing from kind of an odd position like that.
Yeah.
I'd actually prefer to play like that. So too bad for Lynn. He actually mismicroed his Marines, if you notice. They were shooting the depot.
Yeah, that was actually a huge part of it. You have to put them on the move command. If you're just attack moving up, they're like, okay, it's a depot. Cool, dude.
Like, whatever you want me to fight. You want me to shoot? You want to shoot this building there?
That depot isn't my friend. I'm going to go after it. All right, let's take a look at the match results from today. OGS Top against SC4U. He took him out, Tasteless. Then Zenix Bjorn takes out Fox Lynn. That's going to be at our finals, Code A Finals. That is going to be on January 21st. Isn't that tomorrow?
It is.
That is tomorrow.
We have the finals tomorrow here. OGS Top against Zenix Bjorn. Can't wait. Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. And now for the Code S semifinals.
That is going to be on Sunday. I'm Nesty against I'm MVP. Liquid Jinro against Marine King Prime. That is going to be epic, Tasteless. Epically epic.
Epic, amazing.
The epicitude of that is epically outstanding.
If I could get my epic meter, my little epic seismograph, and going,
the glass would break.
Yeah.
Make sure you have a mask on, some protective goggles.
All right, I'll be sure to do that. Thanks to our sponsors at Sony Ericsson. We love you guys. You guys are the best. And let's take a look at the Code A registration.
You have till the 22nd. It's right there. There it is.
Check it out.
Yeah. The finals of Code S are going to be at the Jumshill Student Gymnasium, Tasteless. And that's going to be at 3 p.m. KST. On January 29th. That is a Saturday here.
Please come down. Bring your friends. Bring everybody you can. Or tune in live for the GSL finals as well. Get your friends over.
Yeah.
Get some popcorn out. Maybe some soda pops.
Yeah, man.
You know, get you in your pajamas. You know, it's going to be late. Then you can all finish that up, you know, after the GSL's
have
done.
Have a pillow fight.
You could sit around, you know, eating popcorn, talk about girls and stuff, you know, whatever. So we're going to wrap it up, guys.
But
thank you for
up.
Joining us. Enjoy the interview, and I'll see you guys at the Code A Finals.